He said, no, we shall take him, adopt him as our son. We don't have any son. They had no son till that time, Pharaoh and his wife. And this wife was also Israelite. So she has had love for the baby also. And then, Quratun li wa lak, he will be a coolness of eyes for me and you. So when wife is requesting, and she was a beloved wife of Pharaoh, so he stopped. And himself, Musa, you know, he had that reflection of divine love. Whosoever saw him, he started loving him. وَعَلْقَيْتُ عَلَيْكَ مَحَبَّةً مِّنِّي وَلَتُسْنَى عَلَىٰ عَيْنِي, so that you should be brought up before my eyes. استمشي أختك, when your sister was walking, when you know the water of Nile was taking the chest, the sister was going on the coast and watching what happens. And when this chest reached the palace of Pharaoh, she went there. And she said, استمشي أختك فتقول هل أدلكم على من يكفله. Now what happened? Many women were called for suckling this child. He must have been someone to suckle him, but he never took, you know, in his own mouth, never took into the mammary gland of any woman in his mouth. So it was a problem. How will you keep alive? Now the sister said, if you like, these details are given in other parts of Quran. You know, the mention of Hazrat Musa alayhi salam is the maximum in Quran regarding all the prophets and the messengers of Allah. 1/13 of the whole Quran consists of the story of Musa alayhi salam. 555 ayat out of 6,500 ayat. They relate to Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. So she said, "Hal adullukum ala man yakfulu? Should I lead to you a family? To you that can keep this child for you?" فَرَجَعْنَاكَ إِلَىٰ أُمِّكَ. In this way, we return you to your mother. كَيْ تَقَرَّ عَيْنُهَا. So that her eyes remain cool. وَلَا تَحْزَنْ. And she should not grieve. وَقَتَلْتَ نَفْسًا. We shall read this story in detail in Surah Al-Qasas. But here it's a summary. But then you killed a human being. فَنَجَّيْنَاكَ مِنَ الْغَمْ. We saved you, delivered you from the grief. وَفَتَنَّاكَ فَتُونَا. And then we kept on trying you in different ways. فَلَبِسْتَ سِنِينَ فِي أَهْلِ مَدْيَنَ. Then you ran away from Egypt. You stayed with the people of Madian for a number of years. ثُمَّ جَئْتَ عَلَىٰ قَدَرٍ يَا مُوسَىٰ. And then you have come over here by the destiny that we fixed. You have not come yourself. It's the destiny, our destiny. We had decided it. We have been watching you through all this period. And we have prepared you. وَاسْتَنَعْتُكَ لِنَفْسِىٰ. Very beautiful words. I have prepared you, chosen you for myself. So, a very heavy mission is going to be entrusted to you. ثُمَّ جَئْتَ عَلَىٰ قَدَرِي يَا مُوسَىٰ. Taqdeer. Taqdeer has brought you over here. Our command. And we have prepared you specially for this purpose. إِذَا بَنْتَبَ أَخُوكَ بِآيَاتِ. Now go you and your brother with my signs, miracles. وَلَا تَنِيَا فِي ذِكْرِي. And don't be slack in remembering me. إِذْهَبَا إِلَىٰ فِرْعَوْنَ إِنَّهُ تَغَىٰ. Now go both of you to Pharaoh. Verily, he has become very tyrant. فَقُولَ لَهُ قَوْلًا لَيَّنًا. But say to him, you both, very gentle word. لَعَلَّهُ يَتَذَكَّرُ يَخْشَى. Maybe perchance he gets the admonition or he gets the fear of Allah in his heart. Don't be harsh. Talk to him gently. Now this is very important. A muballigh and da'i shouldn't be harsh. He should be very soft in his address. قَالَا رَبَّنَا إِنَّنَا نَخَافُ. Both of them said, Musa and Harun, O our Lord, we fear, أَنْ يَفْرُطَ عَلَيْنَا, that he must, might hasten against us. He might take any step against us. أَوْ أَنْ يَطْغَى, or he becomes a transgressor against us. قَالَ لَا تَخَافَا, Allah said, don't fear you both. إِنَّنِي مَعَكُمَا, verily I am with you, don't fear. إِنَّنِي مَعَكُمَا أَسْمَعُ وَأَرَى, I'll be listening to everything, I'll be seeing everything. فَاتِيَاهُ, now go, reach him. فَقُولَا, and both of you should say, إِنَّا رَسُولَا رَبِّكَ, we both are the messengers of your Lord. فَأَرْسِلْ مَعَنَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ, now allow the children of Israel to go with us. They are not the sons of this soil. They came from Palestine in the time of Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam. And they were settled here by the king of that time. And Hazrat Yusuf also was the Aziz of Misr, was a big authority in that kingdom. But now nearly 400 years had passed. That was actually the time of the Hyksos kings. This was not the, he was not a Firaun. He was not a local Egyptian king at the time of Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam. They were the Hyksos kings. Amalites, Amalqa. Amalqa had invaded Egypt and they were reigning at the time of Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam. And they were from the Arabian desert. So actually they welcomed Bani Israel, settled here. And they, you know, favored them. So they prospered. It's 12 families had reached over there, and after 400 years, there were 600,000 in number at the time of Exodus, 1400 years before Christ. Nearly 400 or 500 years had passed, and they prospered and multiplied in number. So now, but then there was a revolt against those Hyksos kings. They were, you know, beaten away, and now it was the local, sons of the soil. Now they were the Egyptians who were ruling, the Firaun dynasty. So now they were against these Bani Israel, because they were the favorites of the former kings. So now this is the nationalism, simple nationalism. Just as you know the Biharis in East Pakistan, in the same way these Bani Israel were treated as foreigners, and they were, you know, persecuted like anything. Now Hazrat Musa said, let them go back. Don't persecute them. Inna Rasula Rabbika Fakula Inna Rasula Rabbika Farsil Mana Bani Israel Wala Tuazibhum. Don't persecute them. Qad jainaka bi ayatin min Rabbik. And look, we have come to you with a sign from your Lord. Wassalamu ala mani taba'al huda. And peace would be upon those who follow the guidance. If you follow,